Calling all collectors. If you're a fan of antique cookie jars, you certainly have your fair share of them here just outside of Merrickville. Joining me once again, Joan Little, owner here at Walnut Grove Treasures. What an appropriate name for your shop.
I know.
It is. Such a huge collection of little treasures everywhere.
Yeah, it's a mixture. Mm-hmm. A lot of different things, Majolica, Chintz, Royal Bayreuth, Carnival Glass, the list goes on. Mm-hmm. I have a passion. Also, I have a passion for cookie jars, and one of my favorites is over there in the corner, and the little girl, mm-hmm. and that's made by Lefton, and they made a lot of cookie jars.
And what's nice too is if you come to Walnut Grove Treasures and you don't see what you're looking for, you've got something specific, Joan can write down your contact information and keep her eyes peeled in
That's
all of
right.
the different places that you pick out your different items.
And it's worked out too. I find I make quite a few calls.
Of course. Well, I would imagine. Okay, so we've been talking about jewelry for a good chunk of the morning. I've got another one of your gorgeous homemade pieces
Thank
on.
You.
It's what type of stone?
Agate.
It's an agate. And now it's not just necklaces, which we have to point out these two on the mannequins because they really are catching. You've got so many different elements in each of your pieces.
Yeah, I try to look for different styles. Mm-hmm. So what people are looking for, I keep up to date on the current trends. Right now it's long, so I sort of gravitate towards long. And those are the purse blings.
One of your best sellers?
They are. Actually, they attach to the zipper on your purse,
uh-huh.
and I make them according to what they want, mm-hmm. Their colors and their color scheme, gold or silver, and they're a good seller.
Okay, so now in terms of pieces that you aren't necessarily making but you're collecting, you've got a nice assortment of brooches here. Where have you found these?
I find them all over. And it's something that I pick up. I tend to look for the jewelry mm-hmm. when we go out. And they're very reasonably priced. Mm-hmm. And I just find brooches are coming back in style now.
Well, it's a way to jazz up a rather ordinary sweater or maybe make a piece of your clothing a little bit more versatile, right?
That's right.
Now, bridal jewelry, is it difficult to find?
No. I tend to make quite a bit of it,
mm-hmm.
But I also pick it up as well. The little ones here, mm-hmm. they tend to be hot right now. Mm-hmm. And it's just a mixture.
Okay. Before we go, there's so much to show. We could spend the whole morning here. We've got some lovely prints laid out, but let's take one last glance at the man room because I think people hear collectibles and they hear jewelry, and the men at home think that it doesn't appeal to them, but I am looking at a number of things.
Oh, we have fishing lures, we have traps, we have old gramophones,
mm-hmm.
Books. Anyone who's a book collector, I look for the old ones.
Mm-hmm.
Ships. Excuse me, old lamps.
A little bit of everything.
A little bit of everything. Lobster trap, right there.
Yes. Joan, thank you so much for having us this morning.
Thanks. Sarah.
Luckily, we managed to film throughout the entire morning and not break anything, which I think is a feat in and of itself. So, congratulations to our lovely
Thanks.
Cameraman. But definitely make the trip out to Walnut Grove Treasures just outside of Merrickville. You've got so many things to discover.
Thank you very much.
My
it
pleasure.
Was a pleasure.